Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is KJ Ricardo, and today's episode is a classic film review on Little Women. This is a 1949 film starring June Allison as Jo, Janet Leigh as Meg, Margaret O'Brien as Beth, Elizabeth Taylor as Amy, Peter Lawford as Laurie, and Mary Astor as Marmee. This is a classic film based on Louisa May Alcott's 1868 novel, Little Women. Little Women is one of my favorite stories of all time. It's about four sisters who are very different from each other, but they're growing up together during the American Civil War. The novel details their passage from childhood innocence into womanhood. I think everyone can identify with one of the March sisters. Personally, I connect with Jo March because I'm a writer, but also I relate to Beth because I feel like I'm a lot like Beth personality-wise. Little Women can be classified as a Christmas novel and movie because it begins in winter at Christmas time and then it ends with their father coming home for Christmas from the war. This is a great family story, and you're always in the mood to watch a family movie during the Christmas season. June Allison as Jo March, she was actually 32 years old when this movie was released, and she was playing a 15 to 16-year-old teenager. But you don't really notice her age, which is always good. Jo hates change. She doesn't want her sisters to get married and leave. She doesn't want to get married herself. They have already experienced enough change with the war and their father leaving to go off to the war. And so Jo loves her sisters so much, and she doesn't want anything to change. But then she meets Lori, and there's definitely some romance between them. You want Jo and Lori to end up together. And this dates back to the original book by Louisa May Alcott. Jo and Lori have so much chemistry together, and they are very compatible. They should end up together. They're a perfect match. Louisa May Alcott actually received so many fan letters from fans who were actually angry that Jo and Lori didn't end up together. But Jo is so against the idea of marriage that she rejects Lori, and it's very heartbreaking to watch.
I've loved you ever since I've known you, Jo. Couldn't help it. I've tried to show you, but you wouldn't let me. Now I'm going to make you hear and give me an answer.
I wanted to save you this, Laurie. I never wanted you to care for me, so I tried to keep you from it when I could.
Oh, I just can't go on without you, Jo.
Oh, Laurie. Laurie, I'm so sorry. So desperately sorry. But I can't say I love you when I don't.
Really and truly, Jo.
Really and truly, Laurie. I don't think I'll ever marry.
Jo is regarded as an early feminist literary icon because she is so against marriage. It's the 1860s. She's expected to become a wife and a mother, but she doesn't want that. She wants to be a writer. She's different than what society expects her to be. And so June Allison did a great job in this movie conveying all of these emotions. Janet Leigh did a great job in this movie as well as Meg. She is the eldest sister and she's more traditional than Joe. She has different dreams for herself. She'll fall in love and marry just like what society expects her to do. Elizabeth Taylor is just what you expect to see as Amy. She's the youngest sister, and spoiler alert, she eventually claims Lori's heart in the end. She's passionate, and she's also the most suited sister to grow up into a high society family. Finally, Margaret O'Brien was perfect as Beth. She's the quiet and more reserved sister of the March family, and she connects with Lori's grandpa, James Lawrence, played by C. Aubrey Smith, in his final film role. He gives Beth a piano, and it's just so sweet to see them connect with each other, and Beth deserved so much happiness. Margaret O'Brien was everything Beth was supposed to be. Spoiler alert, but Beth dies.
Beth dies.
Beth dies? Is that true? If I keep reading, is Beth gonna die?
It's heartbreaking to watch her die, but it has to happen, and I'm glad that they didn't change that. It's an important part of the story. Overall, this is a lovely adaptation of Louisa May Alcott's novel. This isn't the first adaptation, of course. There were some silent films in the 1917 and 18. The 1933 film starring Katharine Hepburn is also a fan favorite, but there were also other adaptations, including the 1958 TV movie with Margaret O'Brien reprising her role as Beth March. There was a 1978 miniseries, the 1994 film starring Winona Ryder, Kirsten Dunst, Claire Danes, Susan Sarandon, and Christian Bale. This is a very memorable movie as well. And so many others, including the new release directed by Greta Gerwig. I am really excited to watch this adaptation. When I finally get a chance to watch it, I might do a film review of it because I just love the story of Little Women so much, and I'm really excited to watch the new release. But the 1949 film is definitely a good, wholesome adaptation. There's so much innocence, and you can tell how close the March sisters are. They are guided by their mother, Marmee, and you just want to be a part of the March family. This movie features beautiful costumes, set designs, and it is very well acted by everybody in the cast. And so I give this movie a rating of 9 out of 10, a solid A performance. It's a lovely movie to watch, and you can watch this movie any time of the year, but especially for the holidays. And that's it. That's all I have for you this time. I hope that you enjoyed this film review. Let me know what you think of Little Women. Are you excited to see the new adaptation? Let me know in a comment, and I would be happy to read that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with another film review. And remember to always laugh often.